A key component of building a modern workplace is creating tight connections between the people you work with, the content you create, and especially the conversations and meetings you share. So today we're going to show you some conceptual scenarios for how you can create those connections with intelligent devices and services that understand both our physical world and our digital world. Let's start with something we're all familiar with, meetings. Hey Cortana, set up a meeting right now with the smart building team to discuss the new project proposal we're creating.
Sure thing. You are all free now. Where do you want to meet?
Find me a conference room with a Surface Hub.
Okay, Team Scrum Room is available now too. Want me to book it?
Yes, please.
Great, you are all set.
What you can see behind me is a common office meeting room, but this one's different. On the desk, we have a prototype device built on similar technologies to the ones we showed you earlier. It picks up both audio and video that you could pair with AI services and Microsoft 365 to help with key tasks like identification, voice transcription, and even real-time translation.
Welcome, Jamal. Hello, Dave.
The AI services even identify Dave and Jamal as expected meeting attendees. I'm going to go join them.
Good morning, Rana. Would you like to start the meeting?
Yes, please. I know Katie and Julia are coming from another meeting, so let's go ahead and get started. Dave, what's the latest with the smart building pilot?
I've already done some preliminary analysis on the data, and I'm finding some high-temperature outliers. We should discuss it later in the meeting.
Okay, sounds great.
Dave, do you know if we'll have enough of the Yanzi multi-sensors to update the showcase floor?
Actually, I have some concerns about the location of those sensors. We should hold off on doing a one-to-one replacement until I can...
Oh, I'm really sorry to interrupt, Dave. I actually have some ideas about the replacement, so maybe let's connect after the meeting.
Okay, that's good to know. I'll follow up with my team and post an update to the channel after the meeting.
And I'll follow up and send Yanzi an email about those showcase sensors.
Okay, that sounds great.
Now, take a look at the transcript behind me on the left. Even though we were all speaking over each other and the sound environment here is actually pretty challenging, the AI services coupled with the audio and video signals from the device could still accurately identify who was speaking and when. You'll also notice that it picked up our meeting items and listed them on the right. And the voice recognition model has been trained over time to understand our team's unique communication style and recognizes our speech patterns even when we're speaking in business jargon. This not only helps the interactions in the meeting room, but it helps remote participants have a more active meeting experience. Our remote teammate in China can see and hear a translation of this meeting. In fact, we can support multiple simultaneous translations. Hey, Katie. Hey, Julia.
Hey.
With Microsoft Teams, we can continue this conversation right within the context of the work we're creating together and the business apps we use to stay on top of our project. I can even access great third-party apps like Trello and GitHub. But now Cortana is in this workspace with me, so she can help me stay connected across all my experiences. As you can see here, Cortana has detected that we need to find a time to meet. Instead of me struggling to find time that works for everyone's calendar, Cortana will automatically offer up a few options based on our mutual availability. She'll even carry the context of our conversation forward to the meeting details. And just like that, our meeting is scheduled. But Cortana also understands the files we're working with, can detect that I want to share the Q2 sales forecast, and we'll bring the most relevant documents straight into this conversation with my team, so I can share it in just a matter of seconds.
Nice. Hey, even though I came in late, I love that I can catch up and identify everyone in the room. I'm deaf, and I work with a sign language interpreter. The transcript doesn't eliminate the need for my interpreter, but it lets me give my full attention without having to worry about note-taking. This makes it a lot easier for me to bring my engineering knowledge to the table and participate in the discussion. I love getting the meeting note at the end, too. Hey, we need to get started on the smart buildings proposal.
I've already started on the outline, but there's a bunch of elements we still need to include. Creating a proposal like this in the past was time-consuming, not just for me, but for everyone on my team. I'd send emails to experts, search for information I need, and run reports from line of business apps, all just to pull them into the document. Now, since everything is a part of the Microsoft Graph, I never have to leave my document, which means that I can stay focused, ask for what I need, and it just shows up. As I'm working on my document, I can add a simple reminder as a placeholder. Or say, I want to get a customer quote from my colleague, Patty. So what I'll do is I'll at mention Patty and ask her to please provide that great customer quote. Now in the past, I'd have to switch from Word to Outlook and run the risk of getting sucked back into my inbox. But now, Patty's quote will show up in the document exactly where I need it. And what's great is I can keep working. So let's do that. Lastly, I want to provide some more information about the Yanzi Smart Building Sensors. So what I'll do is at to do and remind myself to insert the Yanzi information here. Now this is my favorite part. Cortana has remembered that I've used this phrase before. Saw my intent from the to-do item, and then suggested the information I needed using AI. And in case you didn't notice, Patty's information showed up right as I was doing it. The graph becomes richer the more we use this service, and will better understand our intent. In the future, developers will be able to connect and extend their own applications and data sources to the graph, and have that information show up in the document exactly where you need it.
Great. Thanks for that update, Jamal.
Anytime.
Katie, what's the latest with the common area designs?
I've been texting with James. Let me take a look. As an engineer, I spend a huge amount of time in front of my PC, but I'm also getting nonstop text messages and alerts on my phone. On average, we open our phones more than 100 times per day. But we think we can do better. With an Android phone and upcoming version of Windows 10. Let me show you two simple examples. As you can see, I'm getting SMS messages from my phone right here on my PC. I love being able to respond without having to pick up my phone and unlock it. It's much easier to type messages on my PC. I can also drag pictures from my desktop. Let me send this over. Not only that, when I get a picture from James, I can use it right away, just by dragging and dropping it into PowerPoint. Let's see how this sensor would look in our common rooms. Looks pretty good. I can also access my phone's notifications and can click on them to open the equivalent Windows app or see them on the web. Here, I'm opening a Medium article on smart building design. I'll send it to the team after the meeting.
Great. Thanks, Katie. Dave, how about we hop into that temperature data now?
Of course. Let me bring up the latest data from Power BI.
Great.
This is the last 24 hours of temperature sensor data. And I can see that most of the sensors are reporting normal values. But I've got these three high temperature outliers. Mm-hmm. Let me reorganize the data by room type. When I do that, I can see that most of the high values are coming from focus rooms.
But we looked into that, didn't we? We didn't find any equipment in the focus rooms that would cause a temperature spike.
Yeah.
Right. But let me reorganize the data spatially, because I found something interesting.
Okay.
These are the actual three-dimensional positions of the sensors with the building plan. But let me add a 3D map layer from Bing for additional context. Now, I think the best way to look at spatial data is using my HoloLens, so I'm going to switch devices. Now I'm going to connect my device to the screen and share my view. Now let's take the hologram that I'm looking at and place it directly onto the meeting room table. In this way, everyone can get a sense of what I am seeing without having us all to wear HoloLenses. Now, I can clearly see that the three sensors giving us a problem are vertically aligned with one another. Let me just put it back. I've also asked my colleague Tal to join the meeting. Hey, Tal. Now, I can see Tal's avatar looking around the data, just as if she was in the room with us. Tal, have you got any insight as to why these three sensors that are in a vertical stack might be giving us an issue?
Dave, there's a hot air duct running from the cafeteria kitchen on the ground floor up to the roof. There were some changes in the kitchen recently. We may be way over spec thermally.
Got it. Maybe we should change the sensor placement for more consistent readings.
That's a good idea.
That's great. I'll follow up with the building manager to check both the hot air duct and the sensor position. Data visualization is a powerful tool for both finding and sharing insights in data, especially when we can collaborate with multiple people across multiple devices.
Using AI in the cloud, everything we've discussed has now been neatly captured as a searchable transcript on the left, and a summary of all of our meeting items have automatically been created for us on the right. Which reminds me, Dave, I need to follow up with you so you can present that data to our leadership team next week.
Great.
Great meeting. Thanks, team.
Anytime.
Yeah.
Today, we've shown you our vision for the future of modern work and how we can leverage the power of AI to connect experiences across our physical and digital worlds. With a range of intelligent devices and services, we can now understand the spoken and unspoken nuance of meetings, even when we're not in the room. Carry those insights into our broader team experiences and create opportunities for anyone to collaborate in more immersive ways. Thank you.